Hello, welcome to Champion's Ashes. This is a new guide on how to perform the new installation of our mod with our custom launcher. I have an older video that goes over legacy installation if you're interested in that, but I highly recommend most players use this method of installation as it's much better than before. Our launcher was designed to make sure all our players are on the same version of the mod, as well as make downloading updates and hotfixes easy. It will automatically detect if there's an update you need to download, and you can do it from the launcher without having to download from Nexus again. To get on Ashes, you're going to first want to download the launcher from the Nexus page. You'll get an .exe file called Ashes Launcher. You'll want to move the launcher to your game folder, which is where your Dark Souls 3 .exe is located. Then, double-click the Ashes launcher and the launcher will pop up. If it didn't, you probably put it in the wrong folder. Double-check that you put it in the right one. Here is the 1.3 version of the launcher. It's still an early form of the launcher, so if you're watching this from a future version, it might look a little different from this now. To install the mod, you're going to hit the big install button on the bottom right, and then wait for it to finish loading. After that, you can hit play and the game will launch. There are a couple nice features on this launcher. The update box to the left will show all the latest patch notes and you can scroll through them to read. There's also a very simple enable disable button. You can use this button to always ensure your game is modded or vanilla. If you're the forgetful type, I highly recommend you use this launcher to play vanilla if you think you might accidentally run this mod on accident. You can even add the launcher itself as a game on your Steam, for convenience. Just go to Steam, add a non-Steam game, and then add the Ashes Launcher .exe. You can rename it to whatever you want, and then use that to access the launcher easily at any time. We also have a language toggle button. Currently, we only have a Chinese translation, but we will potentially add more in the future. As stated on the other guide, this mod will ban you 100%. A lot of people are concerned about getting banned on their accounts, and there's a lot of misunderstandings about bans and the banned servers among the community, so I'll try to clear some of them up. First, if you're banned, you still have all the same online functionalities as before. Banned server people can still summon, invade, duel, and basically do any of the stuff you can do in vanilla. The exception is that they can only do multiplayer with other banned people. This is actually a great thing for us because it means it's more likely for us to have multiplayer among us mod players and not vanilla players. Second, it's very easy to keep your main account unbanned and try this mod out on a separate free account. This is the step-by-step of how to create that alt account. It's a very simple three-step process. First, on your main account, or whatever account that owns Dark Souls 3, you're going to go onto Settings, Family, and activate Steam Library Sharing. Then, you're going to create a new account. I'm going to log out and then make a new one as an example. You don't need to create a new email to create a new Steam account. You can reuse the same email you used on your main account if you wanted, as I do here. The same email can be essentially reused for an infinite number of Steam accounts. Now, it's asking for email verification. I'll go to my email and just quickly hit verify. Afterwards, I'll enter my new login info and then I'm finally logged into my new account. Since I already had Dark Souls installed, you can see it there already ready to be played in my library. When I click on it, it asks me to borrow the game. All you have to do is click that button and then verify again that you want to give this account access to that game on your email, and then you're completely free to play Dark Souls 3 on this fresh new account that has no bearing on your main account in any way. Again, you can add the launcher here into your library if you want it. Unlike before, uninstallation isn't really necessary with the launcher disable button in place. If the mod is toggled off in the launcher, the mod won't be active. That's it for the guide, guys. If you have any questions or encounter issues with Ashes or the launcher, please reach out to us in our Discord server linked below. We're always looking to improve the process and get feedback from our players. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoy our mod.